Today we're going to be speaking about one of the most popular sports in the world, not just in the Commonwealth, but in the world, football. And like cricket, visually impaired people across the world are kind of passionate about football. And blind football has been played in different parts of India for the last few years. And there is the Blind Football Federation of India, which I don't know whether I've got the sequence of the name correct, but the speaker will correct me. So we've got the secretary of the body who is going to speak to us about football and how blind people play the game. I am also curious to know how this happens. And the name of the speaker is Sunil J. Matthew, and he also happens to be one of the persons who's been actively involved in coaching the Indian team and organizing tournaments in different parts of India. And he's an interesting speaker, and he's got something very interesting to tell us. So if you have any questions which are urgent, you can put it down in the chat box, and Shruti will make a note of it. Else, when he finishes after 40 minutes, you can ask the question directly. You can raise your hand by pressing Alt Y, and you'll be unmuted, and then you can ask your questions. So Sunil, welcome to Highway Encounters, and it's a pleasure to have you with us.
Hi, George. Thank you for this opportunity, and wonderful to be on Highway. Been following your work, like you know, for a good maybe couple of decades now, George. And our acquaintance goes back to the good old college days. And George also is my senior from my college in Delhi. Just a bit of history there. I was part of the initial volunteer group that helped with the blind cricket initial. I don't know if you still remember Kuriakos B, Alex, coming to you long back.
Yes, of course, of course. Yes.
This is 1997, 98, if I'm not wrong. And wonderful. Yeah. Been following your work, and kudos to all the great work done. I will try and speak in English as well as in Hindi. So that, and I'll go slow, so I know that most of the audience want to understand what has been said, rather than just me finish the entire presentation in 40 minutes. We are always there on Facebook and all our channels, so we can discuss further. Namaskar, mera naam Sunil J. Matthew. Mere Indian Blind Football Federation ka sporting director. Pichle 7 saal se hum blind football ko India mein प्रमोट कर रहे हैं. ब्लाइंड फुटबॉल के बारे में मैं जानकारी में दूंगा मेरे दूसरे हिस्सा में, दूसरे सेशन में. एक दो स्लाइड्स भी है जो विश्वी चैलेंज, हमारा जो विश्वी चैलेंज व्यूअर्स है, उसके लिए मैं मैक्सिमम एक्सप्लेन करूंगा स्लाइड्स में जो मैं दिखा रहे वाला हूँ. मगर वीडियोज भी है, आपको सुन भी सकते हो इफ द वीडियोज आर एबल टू प्ले इन द शॉर्ट टाइम. आई विल डेफिनेटली डू इट, नहीं तो मैं वो वीडियोज जॉर्ज सर को मैं दे दूंगा और यू कैन शो इट टू ऑल योर पार्टिसिपेंट्स. Like I said, thank you for this opportunity. Mera kaam Visually Challenge ke saath college days mein hi hua tha. 1996 to 1999, jab main Stephens Delhi mein mera economics honors kar raha tha St. Stephens College se. Usi time mera interaction with couple of stalwarts from the jo blind communities se tha, including Mr. George, who started the cricket. Uske baad mera curiosity ke saath mera ek NGO bana 2002 mein, uska naam hai SRVC. और वहाँ उसी का सेक्रेटरी हूँ मैं. पिछले 18 साल से मैं और मेरा कोलीग एमसी रॉय इसी में काम में जारी है, जो रिहैबिलिटेशन ऑफ द विजुअली चैलेंज. जिसको भी काम देना वाले हैं उनको काम दे, कैसे काम दे सकते हैं ब्लाइंड लोग को, इसीलिए हमने ये शुरू किया था 2002 में. और काम के बारे में मैं तो इतना जानकारी मैं नहीं दूंगा क्योंकि ये फुटबॉल का सेशन है. मगर मैं जो चाहता हूँ बस आपको यही पता होना है कि वॉट इज द वर्क दैट वी डू इन SRVC. द गोल ऑफ SRVC इज टू फाइंड द बेस्ट ऑफ द विजुअली चैलेंज टैलेंट्स एंड ट्राई एंड ट्रेन देम टू गेट एम्प्लॉयड. सो 2002 वी वर लुकिंग एट द म्यूजिक स्पेस. आप लोग पता है कि टैलेंटेड लोग हैं आप लोग, जिसको भी म्यूजिक में इंटरेस्ट है उनके लिए एक ऑर्केस्ट्रा बनाया 2004 में. करीब 16 साल से हम 400 शोज खेला है, दिल्ली में भी आ सके, दो तीन बार आए हैं, बाहर भी लेके जा रहे हैं, गए हैं ऑर्केस्ट्रा को. उसके 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 उभरी हमने एक ब्लाइंड के लिए एक कंप्यूटर ट्रेनिंग सेंटर, जैसे आईवे करा रहा था पहले, आई थिंक वी स्टार्टेड टीचिंग इन 2006 हाउ टू यूज बेसिक कीबोर्ड्स, यूज जॉस, नाउ इट्स कम टू NVDA, ऑर्का. उसके बाद हमने जॉब अपॉर्चुनिटीज, जिसको भी ब्लाइंड लोग है जॉब इसे कंप्यूटर के ट्रेनिंग के बाद, इसीलिए बैचेस ऑफ 10 लेके हमने 10-12 बैचेस किया था कुछ ही में ही जहाँ पे मैं बेस्ड हूँ, और नियरली 60-70% हम एम्प्लॉयमेंट दे भी वी वर सक्सेसफुल इंक्लूडिंग IBM, सिस्को, रेडबस, विप्रो, कॉग्निसेंट, बहुत सारे कंपनीज में लिया है. इनफैक्ट आवर पार्टनर्स इज एनेबल इंडिया, आपको पता है एनेबल इंडिया का ट्रेनिंग तो मशहूर है इंडिया में भी. उनसे पार्टनरशिप लेके हमने ये 12 बैचेस खत्म किया था. उसके बाद हमने रिफ्लेक्सोलॉजी, जैसे कि मस्योर जॉब, मालिश का जॉब कैसे करा सकते फुट, ओनली फुट रिफ्लेक्सोलॉजी, इसीलिए हमने एक अलग का एक प्रोजेक्ट बना दिया. और उसी के ये प्रोजेक्ट तो हमारा ब्लाइंड फुटबॉल एकेडमी का भी एक हिस्सा है. और चौथी है असेइंग और टेस्टिंग. ये बहुत ही रेयर चीज़ है, रेयर प्रोजेक्ट है, मगर हम एक दो को भी उनको भी ट्रेनिंग दिया था. वो बाहर से ट्रेनिंग लेके टी टेस्टिंग असेइंग के लिए हमने ट्राई भी किया था इंडिया. ये है SRVC का काम. 2013 में मेरा ब्लाइंड फुट, मैं तो फुटबॉल वीकेंड्स में खेल रहा था. एक बॉल था मेरे साथ, रेगुलर फुटबॉल, और मेरे साथ तो हफ्ते में 3-4 बार तो मैं लड़कों के साथ टाइम बिताता हूँ. उसके साथ मैं एक बॉल के साथ गया था एक शाम, मेरा बूट्स के साथ. तो एक लड़का ने पूछा कि सर ये क्या है, तो मैंने बताया एक फुटबॉल है यार. तो वो फुटबॉल रख के, सादा फुटबॉल, एक फुटबॉल रख के वो 3-4 स्टेप नीचे लेके एक रन अप लेके एक अच्छा शॉट. मैंने पूछा यार ये कैसे खेला, कैसे शॉट था ये 2013 में. तो उसने बताया कि सर मुझे आई कुड सी एंड नाउ आई कैनॉट सी, बट आई लव फुटबॉल एंड आई लव टू प्ले. केरला में मशहूर है फुटबॉल, यहाँ का एक स्पोर्ट्समैन कल्चर है, आपको पता है यहाँ के एथलेटिक्स नंबर वन है PT उषा के साथ. और हम करीब हर साल एशियन गेम्स और ओलंपिक्स के लिए केरला से एथलीट्स जाते हैं. फुटबॉल में भी मशहूर है, क्रिकेट में भी मशहूर है, स्पोर्ट्स में नंबर वन है शायद अप देयर इन अमंग्स ओडिशा एंड अदर स्टेट्स, मेरे ख्याल से इंडिया में ही. छोटा सा जगह है केरला, करीब 30 लाख का पॉपुलेशन है, मगर यहाँ का ब्रीड अलग ही है. क्रिएटिविटी और स्पोर्ट्स यहाँ पे बहुत मशहूर है, इसीलिए मेरा ख्याल था कि ये ब्लाइंड लोग फुटबॉल तो खेल सकते हैं यार. मैंने शाम को ही गूगल किया ब्लाइंड फुटबॉल, और आ गया रिजल्ट्स. डेविड बेकम से करीब हजारों रिजल्ट्स निकल रहे हैं. मैं देख रहा था कि इंडिया कहाँ है इसमें, रिजल्ट्स में इंडिया कुछ है, कुछ भी नहीं. तो मैंने रिजल्ट्स से जाके एक UK वाले मेरे फ्रेंड को बताया कि यार एक ब्लाइंड बॉल चाहिए, ये ब्लाइंड फुटबॉल जैसा एक बॉल. उसने बताया कि ये बॉल कैसा होता है. मेरे पास एक बॉल है, आपको, आप ये सुन भी सकते हो, पता नहीं कि ऑडियो आपको है कि नहीं. ये बॉल, बॉल के बेल्स आप सुन रहे हैं. ये बॉल साइज 5 का फुटबॉल है, हम जो खेलते हैं साइज 5 और 6 से खेलते हैं रेगुलर फुटबॉल. ये 4 और 5 का साइज है. बॉल के बिल्कुल इनसाइड लाइनिंग में बेल्स रखा है, जैसे कि बॉल बेयरिंग के साथ आप खेलने वाले हो. और बॉल को थोड़ा सा टफ माने कि हार्ड मटेरियल से बनाया है, माने कि आप अगर ये वॉल में जाके बैंग करेंगे या साइड बोर्ड में जाके बैंग करेंगे तो भी ये बॉल का शेप नहीं जाएगा. तो मैंने एक बॉल निकाला UK से, एक बॉल तो कुछ ही आया. मेरे साथ 6-7 लड़के थे वो रेडी टू प्ले. मैंने गूगल करके उसको रूल्स सिखाया, और मैंने फिर गूगल करके देखा कि यार ये बॉल के साथ ये भाग रहे हैं मगर ब्यूटिफुली वो टैकल भी कर रहे हैं, ये कैसे हो रहा है. तो मैंने फिर चेक किया, तो इंडियन ब्लाइंड स्पोर्ट्स एसोसिएशन जो न्यू दिल्ली में है वहाँ पे मैंने कॉन्टैक्ट किया, और मैंने बताया कि वहाँ का जो सेक्रेटरी डेविड सर को बताया कि आके आप हमें एक थोड़ा सा ट्रेनिंग दे दीजिए तो अच्छा रहेगा. 2013 मई में वो आके हमें थोड़ा सा बेसिक बॉल कंट्रोल का ट्रेनिंग दिया, और आके बताया यार सुनील व्हाई डोंट यू कम फॉर आर नेशनल्स. तो मैंने बताया कि सर हमें तो खेलना नहीं आता यार, बस शुरू किया. एंड पार्टिसिपेट इन आर नेशनल्स, यू विल गेट गुड एक्सपीरियंस. तो गए थे विद नो एक्सपेक्टेशन. वी वर लेटर टोल्ड दैट वी वर द आई थिंक द फर्स्ट और द सेकंड टीम एवर फ्रॉम द साउथ नेशनल्स जाने के लिए, और हमने सीधा फाइनल्स निकाला. फाइनल्स में हमने 1-0 वी लॉस्ट, बट बहुत ही अच्छा एक्सपीरियंस था. तो मैंने वहाँ डेविड सर से बताया कि डेविड सर व्हाई डोंट वी टेक इट इंटरनेशनल ऑप्शन. उसी साल मैंने देखा कि अगस्त में एक टूर्नामेंट हो रहा था थाईलैंड में, 7 टीम्स का टूर्नामेंट था, रशिया था, बहुत ही सही टीम्स था, ईरान था. तो मैंने बताया कि डीप एंड में ही जाएं, हम उसमें ही कूदें, देखेंगे कि कैसे होते हैं. अगस्त में हमने एडिडास और एयर एशिया से स्पॉन्सरशिप निकाल के हमने अगस्त में 7 टीम का टूर्नामेंट के लिए गए थे, और उसी टाइम पता चला कि रूल्स तो बस इसमें सारे रूल्स अलग है. करीब 64 रूल्स है यूनिक. ब्लाइंड में ही डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज है, जो टोटली ब्लाइंड है उनके लिए एक 5 जन का फुटबॉल है, जो स्पेशली है, माने कि उनको भी सात लोग, सात जन का फुटबॉल है और विमेन्स का भी अलग हो रहा है अभी, तो उसी के साथ हमने थोड़ा बहुत वहां के ट्राई किया इंडिया ने, गोल तो खा लिया हमने बहुत, मगर एक गेम में तो हमने जीता भी था हांगकांग के साथ, उसी के साथ हमने सेमीफाइनल गए, सेमीफाइनल तो हमने हार दिया, मगर एक ब्यूटीफुल एक्सपीरियंस था। और आईबीएसए से बोला कि सर ये मोमेंटम नहीं छोड़ना है 2013 में, हम बच्चों के साथ हम फुटबॉल सीखेंगे, तो इसी के साथ हमने शुरू किया। 2014 में भी एक नेशनल खेला आईबीएसए के साथ, उसके बाद हमने एक अलग का फेडरेशन बनाया जो आईबीएसए दिल्ली के साथ अफिलिएटेड है और पीसीए के से, जो आपको पता है पैरालंपिक कमेटी के साथ, और हमने ऑल इंडिया फुटबॉल फेडरेशन जो इंडिया का फुटबॉल चलाता है उन सबसे हम अफिलिएटेड। तो ये है ब्रीफ जो हुआ था। मैं अभी थोड़ा एक स्क्रीन शेयर करके आपको हमारा प्रोफाइल और जस्ट जैसे कि जिसको भी इंटरेस्ट है मैं उनको बस दिखा रहा हूँ कि कैसे जो हमारा प्रोग्रेस था वो कैसे हुआ है। George, I just, if someone can just confirm if anybody's seeing the screen.
Yes, you, yes, we can see the screen.
Yes, you can see the screen.
Now we've gone back to this view, you just, yeah, you were just able to see it.
Yeah, yeah, just a second. Are you able to see this now?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. Okay, here we go. So, ये मेरा थोड़ा सा history है. जहाँ से हम आए थे।
सुनील,
yes. सुनील, I'm going to explain that, George. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, speak a little more in English.
Okay, okay, fine. Okay, I can do that. Great. You help me out here, George. All right, thanks. So, well, I'm just going through the screens. I'm just reading aloud what I wrote here, so everybody knows. Down the line, what has happened after 2013 is we have created the Indian Blind Football Federation. 2016 it officially came into being. With that, we've been actually quite working across, actually. In fact, the best thing that has happened in 2018, I've been personally nominated into the World Blind Football Committee, which is an elite group of 8 people. So we work in about 64 countries and I represent Asia in that committee. So we decide for a number of rules that come into the game, specifications on how to improve the game and work with the standards. All this is my voluntary work, actually. I run an IT company of my own and nobody in my family or anybody is blind. But the passion is working for the community and with the differently abled. So whatever it takes to actually try and get the differently abled to showcase their skills and get them a job is why I'm doing this. I otherwise run a software company. I also have a startup of my own working with the IT sector for the blind and the elderly. It's called Saitika Solutions. It's all in this slide. Okay. The Indian International Blind Sports Association. So International Blind Sports Federation. What we do here is we govern the game, like I said. We take blind football to the root level across the world. In India, our affiliate partners is the IBSA New Delhi, and we are now under them, so we work with them. The major championships that we work with, we create world championships, we have African championships, we also conduct the Paralympics. We recently went for the Paralympic qualifier. India didn't qualify. But the best part is India's fifth in Asia. October 2019, we were able to achieve. We are also 28th in the world. This is our ranking is we are from about 52 countries, but right now nearly 64 countries play the game. I want to create a little bit of, you know, interaction also. So maybe I'll just play a video here to just, you know, get the whole crowd in the mood. So if you permit me. You see the screen?
Yeah.
The sound?
Is there an audio? No, we can't hear the audio. Yeah, now we can.
Yeah. Can you hear?
Just play from the top. No, we're not able to hear the audio.
You're not able to hear the audio, is that?
No.
Oh, just a second. Let me get. I need to, or I can always.
You need to turn it up or something.
One second. I can obviously share the videos later. It's all in the, it's all in my drive. So it's all in the slides. I can share it. Whoever wants to just see the videos can take a look at the videos.
Okay.
So we're just explaining, showing some clips of how the training camp in Delhi was. We had come there in October 2017.
Yeah.
Okay, so basically I run the video, George. I don't know, I'm not getting the video on it, but the videos are all on file, so you can share it. We were just trying to show certain things in the video where how it's come in. So these videos are all on YouTube as well as on Facebook. Now just going into blind football, what it is. Blind football is a five-a-side game. It's played in a ground of size 40 meter length by 20 meter width. Now the unique part is it's got a mix of futsal, which is like a football, five-a-side, and a basketball rule combination. So you have the players who can be substituted on a rolling basis. That means a single player can come back into the ground any number of times. So there are limits of substitution in one half. It's played in two halves of 20 minutes each, so with a 10-minute break in between. But the same player can come in the first half and come in the second half. It's not a problem. But maximum number of substitutions per half is six for the entire team. Now the beautiful part is the players are given a particular rule to play with. So as soon as you have possession of the ball, like I said, there are five people, out of which four people are compulsorily totally blind in a B1 category. You may know that B1 category extends to a visual acuity of 2.14, which is roughly, if I say 90% blind, is under this. You can have the perception of light. But what we do is we cover the complete head with a head guard, and we completely block your eyes with a head guard. It acts in two ways. One is it protects you from taking a hit as you go head on. And secondly, it also gives us a cushion that you cannot see the ball. Even if you can perceive light, some people do perceive light if you close your eyes, you can sense light. But with the covering on your head, it's called an eye guard. So we completely block you off. Before that, I was just showing in the video, there are tapes put and etc. So that is separate. The game is played in a futsal size ground. The best part is the futsal size ground has got long sides, rectangle sides. So the longer sides have got these boards. Like these are side walls. We can call it side boards, side walls, whatever it is. It's of roughly 4 feet height. 4 foot ka height hai. So you cannot fall over it. So you can run into it, but you don't fall over it. So it's like a carom game. Imagine your carom game. The ball is continuously in the game. But the best part is there is no side out throw-ins, and it's very fast to play. Like I said, there are about 64 rules. The number one top rule is if you don't have the ball, agar ball aapke paas nahi hai, you have to keep and you hear the ball coming to you, wherever it is with a player, you have to keep saying the word called boy, V-O-Y. You cannot say boy or Roy or whatever it is. You have to say boy, V-O-Y, clear to the referee. There are two referees. And it means I am here. It's a Latin word universally used across, not only India, across the world, we play with this. And it's got a coach on the long side in the middle, like in football. The goalkeeper has got sight, wo sighted goalkeeper hai. So he can control the game from the back. So imagine you're the defender, wo aapka remote control hai. He's controlling you saying, go by, go left, go right, go left. The center pitch belongs to the coach in the side. Jo bahar khada hai, wo coach can see. So he's guiding the center side. And the attackers are guided from the goal guy who's behind the opponent's goal. So goal post ke piche, opponent's goal ke piche, a guide hai. He's got a stick also, and which guides the goal post. It's fantastic to play and see. Jisko bhi experience tha khelne ka, you'll love it. Though I must say it is very physical. You have constantly chances of getting hit, injury ka chances hai. But that is the spirit of the game. We applaud the blind people for this. And with that comes tackling, passing, shooting. And sometimes the goals are even 20-0, etc. Sometimes if it's a tough team, it's 1-0. So you have a lot of goals, a lot of excitement. And I must tell, like George said, in the Paralympics from 2012, when the last London Paralympics happened, 2016, and now this year, unfortunately, no, but next year, hopefully, it's sold out. Yeah, blind football ka ek bhi game ka ticket nahi hai. It's sold out before one ball is kicked. So it is so popular. Now it's going to be in Japan, where Japan is one of the leading nations in Asia also. So their blind footballers are on billboards. If you land in Tokyo and you go, you still look around, it's like Dhoni and Virat on billboards. Their blind footballers are out there. So that's the passion of the game. They have a league where India is trying to aim to do. So anyway, I just mentioned this. There's a coach and a guide, and there's a video for this. I'm going to share that video. Some of our videos are in Hindi also. So I'm thinking the video will help you. Also, the time is limited, so I cannot share everything here. What we do in the Blind Football Federation, like I mentioned, we started with the football part, working with our NGO. It's an offshoot of our NGO, I can say, but it's a totally independent body. It's got 8 governing council members, people from Dehradun, Meghalaya, Bombay, Kochi, Delhi, etc., all on this, including lawyers and consultants. So we have a mixed crowd in our committee. The goal here is to aim to be the first team sport to qualify for the Paralympics. India se koi bhi, as a team, we have not qualified. So it's our individual athletes who have done very well, Muniyappan, etc. But what we want to do is make sure that as a team, we become the first sport. We knocked on the door. We were fifth in the Asian Championships. I think the first 4 went to the Paralympics this time. But we are hoping to do well. So there is also a World Cup for 16 teams. Paralympics mein bas 8 team hai. World Cup mein 16 teams hai. We are hoping to take it there. The goal of this is you play football, but what happens after that? Main to blind hu sir, iske baad main kya kar sakta? Isiliye we have made a vocational skilling program with football. The goal I keep like saying is football is a beautiful engine. Like it's a platform to show your skill, and people applaud you. The corporates applaud you. The supporters are there for it. But beyond that, we want to make you all stand on your feet, train you to get jobs. And that is our aim with our academy we started. I think we are the only academy for parasport come skilling in the country. I don't know. But I think I checked with the NPC also, Paralympic Committee of India. I'm not sure if there is one wheelchair association in Jharkhand who's doing it. But I think we are still the only academy which does parasport and training for jobs. And what the beautiful fact is, we also run a live call center for jobs. So right now, 20 of our blind people, who are some of them are footballers also. In fact, 2 footballers are there right now today. Working from home because of COVID, but 20 people are gainfully employed, and we are trying to get reflexologists in. We are trying to get musicians in. It's a brief of the academy. Those who can't see the screen, I'm just reading it out. We are the only first and only academy. It was inaugurated by our president of blind football from Germany, who had come in 2017. It's based in Cochin. We do telesales, reflexology. We give full time coaching for 6 blind people with their goalkeeper. So roughly about 8 people are full-time with us. Good food, stay, nutrition, gym, swimming pool, yoga, fitness center, unheard of for parasport. We're trying to get that in a model where only overseas teams do it, but in a quiet way. We want to focus this in a quiet way so that there's less publicity and more good work that comes in. So we handpicked the best, and we rotate the players also. Make sure that different parts of India are represented. Mostly the boys are from Northeast. Kerala, there's only one boy. But the best part is mostly from Northeast and Dehradun and Bengal and Gujarat. People are all part of the academy. This is a brief about who we are. I did explain this. I'm quitting that. And what happened post-2013? We coin ourselves the Blue Dolphins. Now, there's a video on that, but I'm going to share it with George, so he can share it with you. You can just Google Blue Dolphins India, and we are called Blue Dolphins. There's a river. The dolphins in the river Ganges. I mean, you can do it. The official Indian, it's called the official Indian mammal, I think. It's an endangered species. The river dolphins in the Ganges are blind. The Ganges river dolphins are blind, and they're totally blind. They don't have eyes, but they sense and they catch fish, and they are in the river Ganges. So I was just doing a bit of research, and I love this word. We have a lot of dolphins in Kerala also, but something very unique in the north is the river dolphins. So we call ourselves Blue Dolphins. The Indian footballers call themselves the Blue Tigers. So we have a whole band of supporters with us called the Blue Pilgrims and the Blue Battalions who support our work. So it's a lot of support that goes into this work also. Like I explained, volunteers, plus corporates, plus like-minded individuals, coaches, referees who come in. So the big events that took place was, one, we went to this picture that is on the screen is a unique time in our history, where India took part in something called as a World Grand Prix in Tokyo, Japan in March 2018. You can see all of us on the screen. So most of us in smart kits with Adidas branding, and although we didn't have any money from any government agency, we managed to pull strings, and including the Indian embassy in Tokyo helped us. And the best part is we land and we beat Japan on their home ground in snow and sleet 1-0. So India was successful in the first attempt, though we lost the next corresponding game. We played Belgium, which is a European top team for football with good facilities. We also drew with them, but again, it was also tough going, but then a great exposure in March 2018 with the Grand Prix. Next, we also had the Australian team come in 2018, same year, to Kochi. We beat them 2-0 and 5-0. They're a new team. Kilingsen Marak, I think, I don't know if he's on the call, but he scored a hat-trick that day. I think the first ever hat-trick for an Indian in an international game. Some fantastic performance by Pankaj and the Dehradun boys in that game also. Falhan from Kochi scored 2 goals in both the games each. That was one good thing. And the latest is last year, in October 2019, we participated at the Asian Championships in Pattaya, Thailand. And there we did fantastic, though it was very tough initially, coming back from China beat us, Thailand beat us. But then we held Korea. Not many Indian football teams have held South Korea. We held them 0-0, almost beat that. A couple of shots hit the post. We have videos of all this. And again, we played for the fifth and sixth place. And we beat Malaysia 2-0 with a young debutant in that tournament, Shivam Singh Negi from Dehradun. He was groomed by Naresh Singh from NIVH, doing a fantastic job with the team there. He scored for India for 2-0. And then I think we should say that Thailand, who ended up fourth in the tournament, went to the Paralympics, but we couldn't. But we are hoping that we can come in and play the World Championships. The next World Championships are planned in 2023. So we are hoping that we can give it a good shot. The next tournament is in 2022, because 2021 is a year off where we catch this Paralympics training. Okay, some international level training too happens. The England FA coaches had come into Kochi. The snapshot is of that. What we do is we have sessions where, because I'm on the international committee, we get the England FA working with us. We have the French national team working with us. We have the Brazilians, the Argentinians, the best of them. The Brazilian coach is wanting to come in and train us. We have a correspondence going on with the Argentinian coach also. So we're trying to get the best in the world to come into India and train. And what we do is in India in return is, because there are teams that in and around India also want to play. Pakistan, Maldives, Sri Lanka. Constantly people ask us, because of blind cricket that George started, I think sport is quite popular within the subcontinent because they follow us also. So there's a constant request. So we had the Maldives coach, the referees and coaches come in. We had a Sri Lankan coach come in. So we're trying to do something with Pakistan. We also want to build blind football across in the subcontinent, which is one of the goals. It's not only India that needs to develop, because Asia is the biggest, got the biggest base for the blind people as such in the world. So why not develop it in India? That's been our motto from the international committee also. And we're doing some work in that. This graph actually shows the number of persons. So I'm just quickly seeing how many people and what happened. 2019, we clocked as much as 165 people who participated in our nationals. To date, we had from 2016 to 2019, you can see that in 2020, we have more than 500 people in our database for just the totally blind. I'm only saying totally blind people who can play. And with that, we wanted to start even the women's side of the football. And the good news is there's another picture that comes. This was a session that we held with the Indian national coach, Igor Stimac. If you know the national team that Sunil Chhetri plays and Sandesh Jingan, both of them follow our work quite a bit. Igor Stimac, we got a chance to exhibit the game in front of the national coach. Very impressed, wanted to know more. So we're working with them. We should have trainers help our goalkeepers. This was another interaction in 2013 with the national team. You can see the picture there, Sandesh Jingan wishing our boys before we went for the Asian Championships. He's also kind of our patron come brand ambassador. Very nice person. Sandesh is one of the most loved footballers in India after Sunil Chhetri. all of you know that. And in the picture is Sunil Chetri holding our friends there. And women's football, like I said, women's football is set to take off because there's a World Cup for women coming in. And the best part is from the committee, we have decided that even the partially blind people who are women can play. So it's only rule being even the partially blind who are B2 or B3 can play women's football. They just need to wear the head guard and the rules of B1 stay. A quick mention to some people may wonder, main toh totally blind nahi hoon, toh how can I play? So there is something called partially sighted football. It's just called B2, B3 football. It's 7-a-side. You don't need sideboards. The ball is also normal ball. You need to have 2 B1 people who are categorized B1. And it is very strict. I may say that considering other sports, our classification mechanism is the strictest in the world. When you go for any championships, we have, India has had experiences of people getting thrown out of championships. I don't think it's happened in any other sport. Kabaddi, cricket, internationally is hardly tested, I think. I must put this on record, but then that's unfortunate. But football, because of it's a Paralympic sport, it's number one for testing. So even if you are on the margin, we don't allow people to come in. So if you have to play B2, B3 football, if you are not B1, that is clear. But for women, we are allowing that rule to just bend a bit. The good news is we have now 4 teams playing. One from Bangalore, a couple of teams from Northeast. There's a gentleman who's developing a team from Nagpur, if I'm not wrong, in Maharashtra. And we're soon having a team from Delhi also, I was told. So 4 to 5 teams are already playing. Next year is the World Championship for Women in Nigeria. So that will be a fantastic story to tell everybody. Blind women beating all odds, coming to play blind football. The whole world is actually wanting India to go. We are hoping that we can find some sponsors to take the team and train the team. We are hoping to have a selection and a tournament before, if COVID settles by then. So we're thinking of this post-September 2021. It was supposed to be this year, it's postponed. This is a picture of our camp we recently did just before COVID in February in Nagaland, in a beautiful place, Dimapur. We had these young boys and girls who I think are 15, 16, till the maximum age of 20. There were nearly 22 of them, full of heart. I can see some of the boys very enthusiastically. They're all in touch with us because we couldn't do much after COVID struck. We had our nationals, everything got postponed. So even the girls who played that day were full of zeal and enthusiasm. So this is partially sighted football. This, like I mentioned, we also have a Kerala team. We played a mix. We play these mixed games. Calcutta has a pretty decent squad. We also had a demo game in Calcutta. We had a demo game in Kerala. Well, we want to make partially sighted football a part of the regular football, though internationally partially sighted does not have recognition in the Paralympics. There is still a World Cup which will be played in 2023, but because it's in England and they have a team. But otherwise, partially sighted football generally is not followed. Like Brazil, who's a champion for football, does not have a partially sighted team yet. So there is a move from the committee to encourage partially sighted football. I think I have about 5 to 6 minutes left. I'll just quickly run through. The latest projects that we've done is one including Asian Football Confederation, AFC as it's called. So FIFA, which governs football, works with the Asian counterpart called AFC. And I've been personally trying to track AFC for a while because from the International Committee of Blind Football, UEFA works with the blind football in Europe, which is fantastic. And they get a lot of exposure for the game there. They get the ball, the kit. Like the balls are quite expensive to buy. The ball that I mentioned, showed you, this particular ball that you hear, it's not very cheap. It's about 2,500 rupees. But the good part is India now is going to manufacture. And the good news is Jalandhar, we found a vendor, vector manufacturer. They ball, make Puma balls otherwise. So we're working with them. We send them the ball. They got the ball almost right. It's been tested. So at a price point of about 800 Indian rupees, we are able to get this ball, which is fantastic because otherwise we have to spend nearly 4 times of that to get it into India. It's not accessible. Second is the blind head guard and the kit. So we make sure that everybody is in complete kit as they go in. Besides this, we have started about 4 centers with AFC. One is in Madurai, Guwahati, Shillong, Joby. Interested here, you can try contacting any of these centers. Calcutta is also quite a vibrant spot. Dehradun, Naresh is leading it. Delhi already has footballers. We also have Gujarat playing. And now Mumbai has been identified as our 4th center. We already have Kochi. We have about 2 or 3 grounds here. Most important thing is getting these sideboards. Jo boards ke bare mein maine bataya. Getting those boards correct is the important thing. Initially, you can put desks, invert the desk from a school, blind school, just play, put 2 sticks. But in a professional game, if you want to prevent injury, you have to get these boards. and those boats are expensive, about 1.5 lakh to 2 lakh rupees for the entire set. So that is one deterrent in blind football, but we are trying to see if we can get this organized. The snapshot of my committee, people from around the world, including the Brazilians. There's some links in this, so you can share it. This is our coaching unit. Mr. Lou from Malaysia, who's also an IBSA referee, saw us in 2013. And ever since then, that's a long time back, he's been associated with the game. He comes into India from Malaysia to train us at no cost. We fly him in with whatever sponsorship money we have. But he's so accommodative, he helps us. That's me in the photograph with Naresh on my right. Naresh is the assistant coach for the Indian team. And along with him is the national coordinator, Rashad. These are my contacts. Coordinates are here. We are on Facebook called Blind Football India. We are on Twitter at the rate, our handle is at the rate Blind Footy. My name is Sunil J. Matthew. I'm also on Twitter, Sunil J. Matthew. My email ID is sunil@blindfootball.in. Blindfootball.in has most of our material that is on. It's also got the timeline, all the videos that I mentioned. Please take time and see it. It's wonderful to see it. What we do is shown aptly in those videos, I feel. And the blind people are our energy, like I keep saying. We are doing what we are because of you people. And every morning when we go to the academy, at least when I go to the academy, I have a selfish reason to go there. I get energized for the rest of the day, seeing those people run and play. And if I can contribute in any little way to improve football and their lives, that energizes me for the rest of the day. So keep playing the game. We also have a website, an app. They're quite vibrant. I think the Blind Football app is live. It's called Blind Football. We are probably the only app for blind football in the world. So if you do a Play Store, Blind Football India, you'll get our app. It's fully accessible. It's done by a blind person himself in my office. So the entire app, entire website, everything is 100% accessible. You can also Google translate it into your local language. If you want it in Hindi, you can translate it in Hindi. Most of our material on training, all our videos are also available online. That's more or less what I had to share. But thank you, George, for this platform. And I am open to taking questions. Yeah. I think I've kept it to exactly the time.
A couple of questions before. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yes. I can hear you, George.
A couple of questions. One is, can you tell us a little bit about the full football gear, right from the shoes to the headgear? What material, and is it the normal stuff or is it different?
Okay.
Number two, you talked about these walls around the ground. Is it all around the ground or only behind the goals? And what material is it made of? And then the third question is, like in regular football, the two teams face each other and they run against each other in terms of taking the ball from left to right and from right to left. In blind football also, is it about moving from left to right and right to left, or is there any other? So, and you said it's five a side. So is it five a side, including the sighted goalkeeper, or is it five plus one?
Okay, George. Great. So that covers most of the doubts, I guess, for everybody. So I'll start with the gear from head to toe. I'll start. So on your head, you need to have what is called, first we ensure that you're in our classification category. If you're B1, B2 or B3, we go through a strict classification with an international classifier. If we have a doubt, we send you to our Indian classifier in Delhi, who then classifies you. So you cannot dodge the system. Like other sports, you cannot hide and dodge the system. That's after you classify. Still, if you can perceive light, what we do is we cover you every day when you play. You will be covered with a gauze, like a cotton. It will be stuck from top to bottom across your eye. So there's no gap in the eye with a gauze, with a cotton gauze. On top of that, we give you this headgear, which is like a head guard. The video had that actually. And sorry, I'm not carrying one here with me. The videos you can
what
see.
What material?
Rubber material. Those are rubberized. So that when you clash, in case you hit head on, you still hit the rubber. But it's hard rubber. It's molded against your nose, perfectly fitting your head with that elastic along the back. So as you wear it, it completely settles into your head. There's no need to strap it, etc. What we do is when we play local games, or if you want to start, if you want to start the game in your blind school, you don't have to wait to get this. This is quite expensive. This is more than 1500 rupees, 1500 rupees per set. So you can just make these Indian, we'll have a 20 rupee one where you make thick foam. Jaise sofa ka foam hai. You take this foam, put it on your forehead, make a shape for the forehead to cover your back. And in the back, use Velcro. So you stick behind and the Velcro and tighten it. So as you go, if the head is smaller, you can change the Velcro size to make it smaller. This is more popular across to cover your head. So you cannot cover your face or your mouth, sorry, because you have to keep saying this word called voi. You cannot cover it. But internationally, you're allowed to use a mouth guard, like boxing or, you know, cricket. Some people wear mouth guards, but it's not comfortable for the person. You're running, you're speaking. Then nothing on your torso, but as you come, you can wear a shin guard at the to cover your shins, which are your just below your knees. Also, when you start, we encourage you to wear knee guards, like these volleyball players wear these knee guards to prevent any sort of scratching of the surface. Earlier used to wear these knee guards primarily to prevent injuries. But also here, what happens is it's also helping you prevent banging against the boards. I'm coming to the boards, George, next. The footwear is regular football shoes is possible, but half studs. Now, studs are under these shoes, which are actually helping you grip in the grass. One thing to note in blind football is you cannot play this in a top of a grass top field. You need to have a turf field, which is used mostly now in these smaller areas. If you go to Delhi, you have about 25 turfs. If you have Bangalore, here in Bangalore, there are turfs. So if you have only an open ground, jaise aapke paas ek maidan hai, you don't have much. To start with, it is fine, but make sure that you cut the grass well along the ground so that the ball moves and has a sound picked up. If you have grass, it sinks into the grass. Ball will sink into the grass and that's why the sound will not be heard. So the ball is constantly moving. So imagine that the ball is moving. So you have to ensure that the ball sound is constantly heard. Only happens if you trim the grass along the ground. So that is the key. One is that. Second is we are also playing these days in hard surfaces. There's a cement court, basketball court, tennis court. Wo bhi khel sakte. If you have an indoor court, jaise aap Ladakh mein ho, or if you are in Himachal Pradesh, where it snows often, or if it rains often, like in Kerala, you have to have an indoor surface also. So we can play in a hard surface. But the most important thing is the second question that you asked, the sideboards. These sideboards are dismantleable. Most of the sideboards are dismantled. So we make the sideboards with material like, you can do it with different material actually. There is iron, which is the frame. The frame is made of nice thick iron. GSM, I'll share the DSM values with you. There is a plank which is placed in between the boards. So imagine you've got a frame and in that frame you have a steel, aluminium, fiberglass, any sort of material other than wood. If you put wood as the plank area, it has to be like a cricket board. Imagine this is like a cricket runner board. Boundary mein jo board hai, but only thing is it's 4 feet. Just like the boundary board, you have to erect it with an angling of 4 to 8 degrees so that it's not straight along the wall, slightly bent. It's okay when you train and all that, it's not a problem. Even when we have it in our academy also, the wall is straight. But when you go for international, it's when you play an international game or host an international game, your boards must be 4 to 8 degrees at a slant. Why? It's primarily because as the blind person comes in, the wall does not become like a proper clashing point. There's a little gap to hold also on top. Also, we recommend a rubber beading along the top on the long sides. Also, what George said was, you asked me if the boards are required on 4 sides or behind the goalpost. No, the answer is no. The boards are required only on the long sides, which are in a rectangle, the long side. So behind the goal is the shorter side. So you definitely don't need that. You need that space open, so that the blind footballer can run and know the end of the ground. Similarly, the long sides, approximate size of these boards are about 6 feet in length or 8 feet in length, but height has to be 4 feet in height. Depth can be depending on the angling. To keep the cricket car runner boards, you can do that. Now, not everybody can get this. This material is quite expensive. Iron, gypsum board. We use what is called multi-wood. It's an international brand that's costing us 2 lakhs, but there are different combinations that come up. Fiberglass is more expensive. It's 4 lakhs. So we use different combinations. Some people use cheaper variety of wood, but we need to make sure that as the blind people runs into the board, it does not crack. And there should not be, the sound also should be perfect as the ball hits. So like I said, like a carom board, but only the long sides have this and the ball bounces against these. The other thing you were asking, the players, how do they play? So just like regular football, it's all the rules of futsal and the basketball, like I said, two teams face each other. There are four blind people, like I said, on each side, and the goalkeeper is sighted. That makes it five. These are the only five people in the ground for each team. And they definitely clash, they run into each other and find, so the goalkeeper has got the ball, he throws it on the long onto the wall. So two people on who are on that side can run to the wall. But as soon as the ball is released or they go to the ball, they have to alert each other by saying, "Voy, voy, voy, voy." So George Voy is different from my Voy, and that prevents injury. And that happens through practice. On day one, you keep your hand out, we teach techniques. Cover your face, keep your hand out and run. But the freedom of running and getting to the ball, holding the ball, tackling the ball, knowing where the opponent is, moving away, it's fantastic to watch. And that comes with a lot of experience. It does not come easily. Like first day, pehle din, you can't just go play and say, "Sir, main saare ko tackle karke goal score kar raha." It's very difficult. You'll have to practice, and that is why we are constantly asking people to train themselves or come to the academy. George, I think I've covered. Anything I missed?
If I might just ask you another question. Yeah. So, you know, this is a very physical game, unlike the regular football, when you push people and all that, it's foul. So what are the fouls here?
Yeah. So there, like I said, there are about 64 rules. I won't be able to go even through even 10% of it now. But the most important thing is, like in football, of course, if you shoulder to shoulder push and the ball is with you, technically in football, it's legit. It's legit. I mean, it's allowed. Here too, it's allowed. But if you push the opponent with your hand, push not the shoulder to shoulder, but you push the opponent with the hand, you know where the opponent is, you hear his voice and you push him away, it's a foul, naturally. If you tackle from behind, it's a foul. If you handballs are generally allowed here because you're blind. So generally it's allowed. But otherwise, if it's a known handball, then you have a stoppage. There is a D, just like football, there's a box. There's a D here, like a hockey D. And you have 6 meter and 8 meter foul penalties. This is the most interesting part. Unlike football, where if you fall in the box in football, you're given a penalty. Here, you create these fouls. Like you don't say "boy," or you create a mistake in the ground, or you go push someone. You get all these fouls accumulated. After five fouls, the sixth foul leads to an 8 meter penalty shot directly. And that's great because these blind people try and score against a sighted keeper. And that usually is fantastic to watch because they train so hard. And 8 meter is not easy, quite a distance, but the blind people are trained to hit that. If you foul in the box, in the D, sorry, and if you fall there, definitely that's a penalty like in football. It's a 6 meter penalty. So most of the football rules are there, except the substitution, these rolling substitution, the timing, especially we also have like what is called as a timer. So you have a timeout system. Like in basketball, you can show a timeout. One timeout per half is there for each coach. So he shows a timeout, the players regroup. You have 1 minute time when you can substitute or whatever and go back. So it's a mix of futsal and basketball is what I can say. These rules are all along our website. If you're interested, just along the right side of the website is B1 blind football rules. There's a downloadable PDF. Then there's a similar yellow card, red card. If you are shown two yellows, it's a red. All the football rules. You definitely need to know. If you ask me, George, what's most important? How do you know these rules? You have to know your football rules basic. Like even a goalkeeper, he's sighted. He can't be like a kabaddi person and suddenly come and stand and say, "Okay, I know football." He definitely, as a goalkeeper, he's a coach. He's got his eyes on. So definitely he controls the game like a coach. It's just that the center coach has only got this area, which is a center part of the push. So like I said, the ground is divided into three. There is the attacker's portion, which is guided by the goal guide, who's behind the opponent's goal. The middle part of the ground is guided by the coach in the middle, and the goalkeeper is guiding the person behind. But to note, as soon as the ball crosses each zone, like if I'm the middle coach and I keep yelling for the ball, which is in the defense or in the attack, I'll be warned and a foul is given against me, a yellow card is given me, even a red card is given against me. So it's fantastic to watch.